In this video, I want to talk about a scripting technique that's actually pretty handy and will be very useful for those of you who are getting kind of to that intermediate level in your FileMaker skills. And of course, if you're an advanced user and you haven't seen this before, this is a really handy one. Now, I want to give credit to Jesse Barnum, who actually showed me this not too long ago. And this is one of those techniques I probably saw previously, but it never really absorbed it as being useful because it's kind of in some ways counterintuitive to how it works. I mean, it makes perfectly logical sense, but you'll see what I mean in a moment. This technique kind of resolves an issue that we run into in the FileMaker platform. And that is the ability to sequentially work your way down a page of code to a point where some sort of condition has occurred and we simply want to exit and jump forward. Now, in other scripting or programming languages, there's this technique called try and capture. In fact, even if you go back to like basic programming languages, you could always execute some sort of code to jump, like a go-to statement that would jump ahead to a specific line number or to a specific spot in the code. And of course, you can kind of do that with FileMaker, but we get into a situation where we want to cleanly write some code, and then if something happens along the way, we kind of jump out and we skip all the rest of the code till we get to a point later in the script and then it picks back up. So this is a practical example of what I'm talking about right here. And this is a script that we have in our copy of FM Starting Point. And this script is designed to do a diagnostic routine to warm up to make sure that the CloudMail plugin is installed. And that is if we've opted to use it, this capability is built into FM Starting Point. Well, the code that Jesse laid on me, it's one that I guess has been around for a while, but you know, if you go to like a developer conference and you hear 100 things, typically your brain's gonna only absorb 30 or 40 of them because your brain's full, right? It's too much to handle. Well, this is one that just for me is kind of new, only from the standpoint that I finally decided to pay attention to it. What they're using is a loop, end loop, script step. Now, the reason I've resisted using this in FileMaker is that because for me, a loop is simply something that rotates and cycles the code around, right? You go through the loop and then it runs again. And typically it'll go through one record, it'll flip through another record. That's kind of the typical use of the loop end loop command. Now, one of the side things that you can do with the loop command as it's running from here to here is that any time we can exit straight out, we can decide that something's happened and we want to exit straight out and we want to skip everything else. And we want to pick up things right after the end of the end loop. So for example, in their diagnostic routine here, this happens and then this happens and this happens. And you come down to a point where you run into a situation where they're looking for some sort of credentials or something. And if they're not there, we say, oh, exit loop, right? So if we get to this spot right here, we have this exit loop. If this condition exists, FileMaker would just bail straight out at line 48, come straight down, and then starts executing code at line 62. It's really kind of a clever technique, and it makes up for a deficiency in the FileMaker platform. The scripting language in FileMaker, while being very robust, really doesn't have the ability to do this try-capture kind of capability. And so, of course, you could kind of work your way around this with a set of if and then else if and then or nested if statements. You could have nested if statements, so if inside an if inside an if, and that can get really ugly and messy. In fact, I really dislike that. When I see this many ifs together, that's about the most I like to see together, just me personally. Anything more than that, my brain starts to explode and I have to map it. So it's really cool that if you come in here, in fact, like this one here, I have to slow down and I have to kind of work my way through it to see what's happening between these sections, right? But if you get a spot where you're just writing code, you don't have to worry about the structure of the if statements. If somewhere along the line, somewhere in here, you get to a spot where things are going good or they're going bad or whatever happens and you want to just like leave, then all you have to do is put in an exit loop. And you put an exit loop 1, which basically means, yeah, exit now. If it's 0, then it doesn't exit, right? Of course, normally you could put an if statement in there, but if you know that we get to this spot and we want to exit, then we just put an exit loop 1. Now you're saying, well, why is the exit loop 1 right here? Well, I guess it goes without saying that as we set this loop up, and we're using the loop for this kind of off-label use, as we say. You know, people frequently will, you hear about some sort of drug that does something and it cures cancer, but along the way it like, you know, solves male baldness or something like that. So it's an off-label use of a drug. Well, this is an off-label use of the loop and in loop command. The problem is if we don't put this exit right here, then this thing's just going to continue to spin. It's going to do what FileMaker intended it to do, which is go in circles. So the whole idea with the in loop is that it never loops. It runs once through, and then either it exits at the very end or it exits somewhere in the middle. It's almost like a one-way loop. It's a one-use loop, goes from beginning to end, and it never cycles back up. But we're using it for the off-label use of being able to forcibly exit FileMaker right out the side of it without worrying about any of the if statements or end ifs or where we're at. We can exit arbitrarily. Now, you could kind of conceivably do this as well with a exit script statement. So say you didn't have a loop in here and you got rid of this loop and end loop, you could actually come through here and say exit script if it doesn't like something. But the problem is at that point, it exits this entire script and goes back out to the parent script. I didn't want to exit the entire script. I simply wanted to exit down to line 62 and then continue to run at that point. So that's the one-use loop technique.